Hello friends, this is Martin from Secret, the channel for learning about trading and investing. Welcome to a brand new episode of Daily Market Analysis, where we look at what happened in the market during the day and also look for what good trade plan can be made for the next day. This is the analysis for November 30th, Tuesday, tomorrow, 2021. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe and share it with friends so that it helps us a lot. In this single market is what we should do. Right, it had a huge dip and then bounced back from the dip. Let's see what exactly happened. So, as usual, we'll be looking at November 32 stay analysis for that, right? And we'll be looking at one of these parameters that you on the screen. Left side, you have what you're seeing on the chart, on the charts, and right side, you have using that analysis, and we'll wrap up with some action numbers as well. So, let's get in and see what was the price pattern. Let's look at this candle, right? It's a doji, pure doji, which indicates uncertainty or indecisiveness in the market is what it indicates. Here, it's a hammer bounce. It's a bounce, but the wick size in both indicates that the presence of the bull side. There are people here buying the downside at this level of 25,000. I handle at this level of $16,800. There are people ready to buy, and there is a gap support that's there here, and it bounced from very close to that gap. This is what happened, right? So finally, if it was 27 points only green, and then to decisions, a 1.5% dip happened around the morning. Right? Bounce was from there. Similarly, magnitude closed green, but just 50 points lost. And we found a hammer candle. Bounce back was from after 2% of morning dip. So heavy selling happened as well as market open, and then somebody was ready there to buy, and then it bounced up. Intraday, that's what happened, right? Morning, it slipped down heavily and the market opened, and then it bounced back both indexes, right? Fortunately, it's the same. It's expansion that has happened on the bear side, and it's working on the bands on the downside. So it indicates clear downside directions. And this is what we see in the Bollinger bands, the volatility is on the downside, clear directions, right? Now, support and resistance levels, not much has happened today. What has happened is the next support zone here that we have is 16,700 and 16,750. It's very close to there, it bounced back and then arrested at the previous support of where it slipped down, which is 7,000 and 7,050, that range. In between, it had a 16,900 Fibonacci 38, which was broken and taken off. And on the upside now, it has resistance 17,250 and 17,300, and then after that, we have 17,350 and 17,450, and after that, we have 17,600 kind of levels. So that's the immediate resistance on the upside and downside. You have 650 current, 16,700 support, which is a very good support, right? Which is a gap support also, right? Window gaps are very powerful. So if that is what we need, we end up in 16,550 the range, and then 16,350 range, and then that's gone. You have 16,150 to 108, and that goes, you get very close back to 16,000 plus. Hopefully, so overall, the market correction has happened up to 10% now on Nifty and 15% nearly from the top on the Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty support levels, you can see it bounced from a support zone of 35,300, and then it even slipped from the previous support of 35,600 and 35,900 range also. It's basically it was nearly 1,000 points of dip that happened. Just 2% of the index had dropped in the morning, right? In a very short period of time. And the immediate resistance upside is 36,500, and above that you have 36,900, 37,100, that zone is immediate resistance, and then you have 37,300, then you have 37,700 and 38,000. Some resistance on the upside immediate, and downside you have supports again, which is breached here. This today it was reached 35,900 level, right? And then below that you have support bounce from 35,000 level, and then that is gone tomorrow, then it goes back to 34,750. So that is also breached, and you have 34,000 levels where it can slip. Right, so the similar resistance and supports with Bank Nifty. Previously, we already discussed the Nifty. Moral divergence we have discussed. Momentum divergence is no divergence that is seen, but monthly, remember, there is a divergence that is there, which is a reverse bullish divergence, can take market up, but it's monthly. The entire December has to finish to confirm that in the January will come down. So, no point discussing here, but just mentioning. Daily, the momentum shows clear bearishness. It's below the RSI 40. Both indices bearishness is very much clear. Trend indicator radix is shown there. The bearishness is rising up on both indices, right? Rising up. The trend strength is rising and it is DMI negative, both, right? Bearishness on the short term. Medium term also just crossed out the bearishness on the short term, bearishness on the medium term also. The weekly chart also showing the radix is crossed out to the DMI negative. Volatility, actually it stood flat today, but it had spiked around 14% and that it went to 23 kind of levels and then it finally settled flat at 20.8, the same as Friday. So which is very high volatility range. This is about 20, is highly volatile and very cautious here. IV, wide volatility is 17.8 and then IVP has increased now to the 56% level, right? So the range formation is not happening, it's just breaking out of the previous range of 15-20, right? The open interest analysis data is clearly showing there is resistance all over. So green all over is called writing all over, right? Today also green got added Bank Nifty and the Nifty. And the open interest data is showing that we have the immediate support at 16,000 where maximum put writing is there and 17,000 after that. Resistance 17,500 and 17,300. 16,000 points is huge. I'm not sure what, you know, option sellers have written the put writing so far, probably hedge positions. But 17,000 is saying reasonable put writing. 17,500 is reasonably 500 points upside where the maximum call writing is. 26.1 is not bearish now. Long build session of Nifty futures data. Bank Nifty 36,000 and 33,000. 36,000 is maximum. Put writing and then call writing is 37,000. So long unwind is what happened here. People were long, trying to short. So this will have bearishness on the open interest side from futures. And 0.65 is portfolio share, which is not bearish. You can see. Now the heat map, if you look, you know, this other stock that performed here, Kodak did well, HCL Tech did well, and the Reliance is the same field. Big giants also mean that's why market could recover. So heavy buying has happened on all the major big index movers today for some reason. Sectoral performance in CIC closed green, but the idea was only stock that closed green, which 0.76% in the layer sector mode, I mean, closed green, but momentum is in the bearish ones, we can't. It's in the sideways one, so we have to wait for it to catch up. Metal, indices is 0.4% down. Momentum bearish zone, so we wait. Auto 0.5% indices, and then it's the bearish ones. Momentum is in the bearish ones, we got to wait. Pharma 1% down, and momentum is in the sideways, we got to wait. FMCG industry has closed at 0.6% down, and then it is, you know, we got between the LD 1.6% lost on the downside, and momentum on the short term also is in the real zones. Got to wait for that to catch up with the bull zones. Institutional participation data has been heavy, 31,000 crore of selling in the November so far. Today's data is not published yet. We'll just quickly check if it is published or mostly it will be. It's not clear. So somebody has bought it either FIR deal, right? Heavy buying has happened, an equal amount of selling has happened. So who did that? It will be clear. We have to see the data. As of now, the data is not coming, but both heavy buying and selling has definitely happened today from the institutions, right? Dollar index on the right side, if you see, it was just dipped with a large bearish candle on Friday, but it is again shooting up. Dollar is again shrinking. And you can see that the rupee currency USD/INR pair also is breaking out of the channel top and then attempting to the same resistance as it had failed earlier, right? So rupee is weakened today. Crude oil has dipped heavily on Friday, big crash to 68 levels, but again slightly shot up and consolidated above 70 levels once again. So this much dip is very good for our economy, but whether it will sustain or it will bounce back upwards, we don't know. Gold, you can see that it is consolidating in the base support after facing resistance at the top of the channel of the couple handle pattern. And however, it's lower here, so it's not ready to fall down. But since dollar is strengthened, gold may have dipped for a while. Yeah, the US markets yesterday showing huge 900 point dip. Today the market is not open. So as of now, there is yesterday there was a big moment in the market, in the US dollar market. So we will wait and see whether this is for real tomorrow in the pre-market. As of now, there is greens that is seen, but this is not decisive for anything unless we see that. But be cautious on the big Dow Jones drop that happened yesterday, right? So that, you know, whether it's recovering it or not, we got to see. So two bearish actionables. One is Indusind Bank. Indusind Bank, you can see that it's clearly working on the bands and breaking out of the channel. Some moment is down, trend is down, volumes are all bearish, and charts and volume bands are all saying heavy bearishness. We are all the same. Volume bands showing the bearishness, working on the band downside. One of us dip deep into the bearish zones, and trend is also lost. Hardly any volumes or a red. This can give more potential because it is broken out of major resistance. Like my M pattern breakdown is what has happened. Wrap up moderate bearishness in the short term is what my view is. It's because the bearish chart patterns, the momentum, and the trend on the short term remain bearish. And institutional selling is continuing. Market weeks is at about 20 levels, highly volatile market. So the only view that can be there is it is being bearish. Correction from the top has extended in 10,000 and 15,000 indexes respectively, Nifty and Bank Nifty. But remember that the vertical outlier value of 18 months, it is retraced only Fibonacci 23 level up to that only, even if you consider the 18 months of value. So there is possibility of lot more correction to happen because of the fact that the US tapering is happening in December and the dollar is shooting up and all these factors. So all possibilities are there, right? So 120 has broken out of the range, which is very, it has moved to the above 20 high volatile range. So buyers and sellers will feel the softness, right? Until it settles in a particular range, right? So until then, there will be no uncertainty, there will be difficulty in trading. Premiums will be high, stop loss will be high, softness will be more, right? So, option vertical spread uses will help directional movement play. Now, directional play is difficult because you don't know whether the next movement upside is going to stop or keep going or not. When does it stop? If it is stopping forming a ring, then you can say option selling it benefit. But as of now, that is also not clear. So, play search for the shorting side, no longs for sure until higher high formation level game gets happened. So, that's my view and hope this helps you to form your own view and have a trade plan for the market. Like it, consider giving like button, share to your friends and colleagues. Happy trading and happy learning. Bye.